The history of Namibia has passed through several distinct stages. During the primary war of resistance, many people who survived continued to suffer. They were pushed in the desert where they died of thirst and hunger. The victims did not only die of thirst and hunger, but the German soldiers poisoned their water wells. Survivors of what is largely acknowledged as the first genocide of the 20th century, most of them women and children, were eventually put in places like Shark Island concentration camp. The German authorities forced them to work as slave laborers for German military and settlers. Food in the camps was extremely scarce. It consisted mainly of rice. This led to many of them suffering from malnutrition. Despite those conditions, the Herero people were taken outside the camp every day for labor under harsh treatment by the German guards, while the sick were left without any medical assistance or nursing care. Some of the survivors fled to Botswana under Chief Samuel Maharero. Botswana has become a home of many Herero people who fled the war in the early 1900s. Soon after independence, the first group of the Herero people returned to Namibia. There are still many who want to come back to the land of their ancestors. In the new development of the primary war of resistance, Hendrik Verbo's Bible and whip were returned to Namibia in February this year, which was stolen 123 years ago and was taken to Germany, where it was displayed. Namibian tribal leaders visited Berlin to collect the skulls of 20 compatriots who died under German's colonial rule. 7 years later, in 2018, the Namibians witnessed the return of another bunch of skulls from Germany. German scientists took the heads to perform experiments, seeking to prove the racial superiority of white Europeans over black Africans. In 2016, Germany said it was prepared to apologize in principle, but it is still negotiating with the Namibian government over the form of the apology and how to deal with the legacy of the genocide. While Germany stresses it gives Namibia millions of dollars in development aid to support all the people, the descendants of the victims believe their case should be treated differently. The Obaherero and Nama traditional authorities filed a lawsuit in New York, which was dismissed by a federal judge. However, the traditional authorities have appealed. Namibia and Germany have started with negotiations to pave the way for the reparations and apology. Namibia's special envoy on the genocide, Dr. Z. Ngavire, says Germany is prepared to extend an apology and pay reparations, but they are working out the modality. Namibia seeks billions of dollars in reparations, and the special envoy says Germany has to look at the gravity of the situation and the poverty surrounding the affected people. Namibia is celebrating its 29th year of independence on the 21st of March. But what does independence mean to the Namibian people? The Namibian people paid a heavy price for their independence. The primary war of resistance started way back in 1904 when the Herero people went to war against the German colonizers who had stolen their land and cattle. Soon after, the Nama people joined the Hereros to fight the Germans. By the end of this war, 82% of Herero and Nama people were wiped out. We are standing here at Hero's Acre, which is the shrine to the Namibian fallen hero and heroines of the Namibian struggle. These are some of the leaders who fought in the primary war of resistance.